Students, and welcome back to the new session of science. Today we will start a new lesson, Introduction to Acid and Base. Before we start with the lesson, I hope you all understand the way the videos are being explained. There are various diagrams and the important points given on the slides through which you can go. So today, let us start with the new lesson, Introduction to Acid and Base. If you want any referral point, any referral lessons, you may go through the channel, and there are various videos for science and maths wherein you can find your answers to the questions. Now, introduction to acid and base. Acid and base are the things that we are using it into our day-to-day life, but unknowingly that these are acids and bases. For examples, the food that we eat in our house, the tomatoes, the tamarind, these all substances have acid into it, but we are not knowing about it. Secondly, about bases also we use. For example, the soap that we use, the toilet cleaner that we use for the cleaning purpose, these all are containing base. These are all bases. Let us go through it. Compound imparting sour taste are called acids. That means compounds, the substances which are having sour taste are called as acids. They are soluble in water. They are corrosive in nature. Animals and plants also possess acid in them. As humans, animals and plants also have acid. You will notice that some substances have sweet taste, some are bitter, some are sour astringent. Lemon, tamarind, vinegar or amla like substances acquire sour taste due to the presence of typical compound in them. Such compounds imparting sour taste are called acids. Acids are soluble in water. They are corrosive in nature. Animals and plants also possess acid in them. Acid present in foodstuff are called natural acids or carbonic acids. Now, acids that we have in our food, as I told you earlier, these are called as natural acids or carbonic acids. These acids, being weak in nature, are called weak acids. Some acids are strong in nature. The acids that we eat are very weak. That's why it is easy for us to digest and it is not harming our any system of the body. Whereas if you handle strong acids, you may get injured. They may burn. Some acids are strong in nature. They are caustic, inflammatory. Example, sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, and nitric acid. These acids are also called as mineral acids. Now, acids which are strong are also called as mineral acids. The skin gets burnt when the concentrated solution falls on skin. Similarly, the vapors, if inhaled, can be harmful to health. Strong concentrated acids are converted into the dilute by slowly adding them into water. Such dilute acids are less harmful than the corresponding strong acids. That means strong acids that we have can be diluted using or adding water to it, making them weak. If you taste dilute solution of baking soda, you will find it astringent bitter. Some substances having astringent bitter taste and slippery to touch, example, lime water, baking soda, caustic soda and soap are called bases. Now, what are bases? Substances which are slippery to touch, bitter, astringent, these types of substances are called as bases. Lime water, the formula is CaOH2. Baking soda, it is NaHCO3. Caustic soda is NaOH. Bases are completely different from acids. Chemically, they have properties opposite to that of acids. They are inflammatory to skin in their concentrated form. We know that the distilled water is tasteless. Water is neither acidic nor basic. Now on the screen you may see some points related to bases. These points you have to remember, and if there is any question asked, write a note on base. You can write these points on it. Let's see the next one. Difference between acid and base. Now this is not given there in the textbook, but for your reference I've put this slide. You have to write the difference between acid and bases into your notebook, and you also have to remember and learn these things. Let us see difference between acid and bases. Acids are sour in taste, whereas base is bitter in taste. Acid turns litmus blue litmus red, and base turns red litmus blue. Acid change methyl orange to red, whereas bases change methyl orange to yellow. Phenolphthalein remains colorless. Phenolphthalein gives pink color. Acids do not have soapy touch, whereas base have soapy touch. Acids give hydrogen ions in solution, and bases give hydroxyl ions in solutions. Now the change into color, this will be shown into the school when you'll come to school, or in you all may even see other YouTube videos wherein you can see the change of the litmus paper. The next part is making of natural indicator. How do we make these indicators? Now, what are these indicators? Basically, when we were talking about phenolphthalein, methyl orange, these all are called as indicators. When these indicators are added to any substance, the change in the color will show and tell us whether the substance is acid or base. Now these indicators are readily available in the market. You can directly get it, or you can see it in the laboratory also. You can directly use it in the substance and find out whether the solution is acid or base. Whereas we can also make indicators at home. Those indicators are called as natural indicators. Let us study how do we make this. The apparatus required for making natural indicators are hibiscus, that is shoe flower, rose, turmeric, red cabbage leaves, filter paper, etc. What is the activity? Rub red petals of hibiscus flower on the white filter paper. This gives hibiscus indicator paper. Now when we take this hibiscus or shoe flower on a white filter paper and rub it, the white filter paper will turn somewhat reddish in color, and that would be called as hibiscus indicator paper. Similarly, rub rose petals on the white filter paper. Cut strips of paper, it is a rose indicator paper. Now if you take rose and rub it against the white paper and then cut the rose paper into strips, that paper will be called as rose indicator paper. Take turmeric powder, add little water in it. Dip filter paper or ordinary paper in the turmeric water for some time. After drying, make strips of that paper. Prepare turmeric indicator paper in this way. Put leaves of red cabbage in small quantity in water and heat it. Once solution of cabbage leaves cool down, dip paper in it and dry it. Make strips of dried paper. In this way, prepare red cabbage indicator paper. Now this is the activity which is given in your textbook also. You may try this activity at home. You may take filter paper, which is readily available in the market, and then try to make natural indicators out of the material that you are having at home. See, this is you can see the picture on your screen about some indicators. Turmeric you have, red cabbage, and after using this, there's a beaker in which indicators are directly prepared. Let us see the next part. Take baking powder, add little water to it. Add the solution onto the lime juice, vinegar, orange juice, apple juice, etc., and note the findings. Now what will happen if you add the baking powder with water onto the lime juice, vinegar or orange juice? An effervescence will be seen. Effervescence are the bubbles that are seen in the picture. When you add this, the solution becomes effervescent and the bubbles come out. That is because of addition of baking soda solution in the acidic solution, bubbles come out or effervescence is produced. What do you observe on addition of baking soda solution in the fruit juice? Whether bubbles formed or effervescence came out of the fruit juice? From the above first activity, we came to know that yellow turmeric papers, indicator papers, turn red in certain solution. Similarly, on addition of baking soda solution in the acidic solution, bubbles came out or effervescence is produced. By this simple and easy activity, we can identify acidic or alkaline. If you observe the effervescence, it means it is acidic or alkaline. By seeing the effervescence, or if the color of the paper changes using the indicators, then it will indicate you whether the solution is acidic or alkaline. Now let us see the next part. That is effects of acid and bases on litmus paper. What happens when sour substances like lime juice, tamarind, water falls on the shaba stones or kitchen platform, and why this is happening? Now, when this tamarind, you must have observed your parents, they do not keep directly the cut lemon onto the shaba stone. Why? Because that part of the stone turns out white. Collect soil samples from your surroundings and find out whether it is acidic, alkaline or neutral. Which substances are used to clean greenish stains on copper vessels and to shine blackish silver utensils? These days we directly get pitambari and all, in which there is already tamarind, this citric powders, which will turn this greenish stain of copper into the clear color of the copper vessels. Why toothpaste is used for brushing teeth? Let us answer a few questions. Now, before we answer these questions, we were studying effects of acids and base in litmus paper. What happens? Blue litmus turns red in acids. Red litmus turns blue in alkali. Orange color of methyl orange turns pink in acid. Colorless phenolphthalein turns pink in alkali solutions. That means if you take blue litmus and dip it in the solution, and then the color of the litmus turns to red, then the solution is called as acidic. Whereas if you take red litmus paper, dip in the solution, and if the red litmus paper turns blue, then you may say the solution is alkali. If orange color of methyl orange turns pink when added to the solution to the given any solution, then it is said to be as acidic. Whereas if colorless phenolphthalein turns pink, then it is acidic in solution. These types of experiment we will see in the laboratory during our class. Next is acids. Now, acid is such a substance which gives H plus or hydrogen plus ions in solution state. Example, HCl dissociates in water solution. See, what am I telling you is, when in a solution, if I take a solution of HCl, that is hydrochloric acid, and when I dissociate it, and after dissociation, the hydrogen ions get separated and the chlorine ion gets separated, then that solution is said to be as acidic, because in acids we have H plus ions dissociated. Some examples of acids are hydrochloric acid, that is HCl, nitric acid, HNO3, sulfuric acid, H2SO4, carbonic acid, H2CO3, in cold aerated drinks. Now, the table for this I have shown in the next slide. We will see it later. A dairy diet contains a few natural acids. They are mild in nature and hence they are not harmful like mineral acids. A few substances having natural acids are shown up. Okay, we will see that table later. Let us see some properties. Substances like vinegar, that is used in day-to-day life, has acetic acid. Orange is having citric acid. Tamarind is having tartaric acid. Tomato is having oxalic acid. Curd is having lactic acid. Lemon is having citric acid. Let us see the properties of acids now. Acids are sour in taste. Acid molecules contain hydrogen ion as a main constituent. Acid reacts with metals to form hydrogen gas. Acid reacts with carbonates and liberates CO2 gas, that is carbon dioxide gas. Blue litmus turns red in acid. Now these 5 points which are shown have to be learned by you all. Only if you know these points, you will be able to identify whether the solution is acid or base. The next part is uses of acids. Now where all these acids are used? Acids are used in production of chemical fertilizers. Acids are used in the production of explosive oil purification, medicines, dyes and paints. Hydrochloric acid is used for the preparation of different types of chloride salts. Dilute H2SO4 acid is used in batteries, that is electric cell. Dilute HCl is used for sterilization of water. Acid is used for making of white paper from wood pulp. So there are 6 points of uses of acids which have to be learnt. Now other than this, there are many uses of acids, but as far as the syllabus is related, you will have to learn these 6 points. We have seen that mineral acids are harmful to body. However, several organic acids are present in our body and in plants which are useful to us. DNA, that is deoxyribonucleic acid. It is present in our body and it decides hereditary property. Proteins which are part of our body cell are made up of amino acids. Fat of our body is formed by fatty acids. Now children, this DNA is present in our body. You must have heard before this also that DNA is present in our body, which helps us to decide the hereditary property. Like we belong to our parents is defined by the DNA test. When we do the DNA test, that will indicate us that the DNA of our parents is matching with us and that's why we are their children. Now, proteins which are a part of the body cell are made up of amino acids. Proteins which are present are made up of amino acids. Fat of a body is formed by fatty acids. Next is base or alkali. Alkali is a substance whose water solution gives hydroxide ion. Now, remember, in acid, while you are studying acid, water, when you break it, it gives you hydrogen ions. Whereas when this solution dissociates, it gives out OH ions. This is a major difference between acids and base. Acids after dissociation gives out hydrogen ions, whereas base after dissociation gives OH ions. Example is NaOH. NaOH is what? It is sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide, when breaks off or when dissociates, it gives out Na plus ions plus OH minus ions. Now this OH ion, when it is getting separated, this indicates that it is a base. Examples of base in our daily use are these all substances which are seen on the screen. I hope you have seen in your house also, which are used in our daily use. That is what I was telling you. Acids and bases are used in a day-to-day life, but unknowingly, we do not know whether it is acid or base. There are some formulas of alkali and their use is also given. Hydrochloric acid is written as HCl, sulfuric acid written as H2SO4, nitric acid as HNO3, carbonic acid as H2CO3, ethanoic acid, ammonia, and sodium hydroxide written as NaOH. Now these are some substances whose formulas are very common and are supposed to be known by you all. The same way, that same time I'll tell you all the use also. NaOH, the use is for washing soap. It is used as washing soap. Then, now today for homework you will find out the uses. Because if I give you everything, some work has to be given to y'all also, some activity has to be given to y'all also. So uses for this has to be done by y'all. Find out the uses. Let us study some properties of alkali. Alkali are also called as bases. Alkali has bitter taste. They are slippery. Alkali contains hydroxide as the main constituent. Metal oxides are generally alkaline in nature. Now these 4 points you are supposed to learn them. Let's come to neutralization. What is neutralization? We have seen that acid contains hydrogen ions and alkali contains OH ions, that is hydroxide ions. Salt and water are formed by combination of acid and alkali. When an acid and alkali come together, they form salt. Let us see how acid plus base will give you salt plus water. Example is HCl plus NaOH. HCl is an acid and NaOH is a base. When they both combine together, that will give you NaCl, that is sodium chloride, it is a salt, and H2O, that is water. This chemical reaction is called as neutralization. This is very important topic. A question can come as what is neutralization? For that, you will have to explain all the 3 points given on the screen. Next is, as I told you earlier, I will show you some acids with its formula. There are some acids with its formula, go through it. With this, we complete the lesson as introduction to acid and base. I hope you have understood the lesson. Read the lesson twice. Go through all the main points, learn the important points, and also go through the slide wherever I've told it is important. After this, write the question answers in your notebooks. Thank you for watching the video. Keep sharing and keep subscribing. Thank you so much.